Hey guys, Ronen here. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about the financing scams that get pulled on truck drivers on a regular basis. So in this video, I'm gonna break it down into three parts. Number one, we're gonna talk about all the scams that they pull and hopefully learn something from it. Number two, we're gonna talk about what I believe we should be doing in today's world, how to choose the finance company that's gonna be financing your truck. And number three, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the pros and cons of financing a truck. So let's get to it, the scams that they pull. While doing this video, I really wanted to recommend a company that does truck financing loans. And great news, we were sponsored by truckloancenter.com, a financial institution that has competitive interest rates. Now, with the mention of this video, they have promised to waive their $250 documentation fee. The great thing about this company is that they service both Canada and the US since 2009. I've attached a link to their website and a form at the bottom of this video. If you are in need of truck or trailer financing, they can definitely help. Trucks, vans, reefers, flatbeds, they do it all, and they specialize in it. Either fill out the form below and they will contact you, or if you're in Canada, call 905-760-9797, or if you're in the US, call 1-412-822-0220. Don't forget to mention this video to have your documentation fee waived. I'm sure they can compete for your financing needs. And now let's get back to the video. So number one, the financing interest amount. So usually in 2021 now, somebody with really good credit should not have a hard time finding finance company to finance the truck between 7 to 9%. Somebody with mediocre credit should be able to find a finance company to finance their truck from 10 to 12%. When we plate owner operators' trucks at the company that I work for, I usually see the bill of sales. I usually see the finance agreement. And it drives me crazy when I see somebody that owns a house, has been working for the last 10, 12 years, and then I see his lease agreement, and I see the interest rates that they charge him are 18, 19, 20%. It drives me nuts. And then I look at the company of who financed it. It's a Mickey Mouse operation that nobody's ever heard of. So the interest rates are definitely something that you have to look at before signing. The second thing where they pull off their scams is with the documentation or processing fee. Well, they shouldn't be really charging you a fee of $500 to $1,500 for an application, because this is their job. They are a bank or they are a financial institute. They should be financing your truck without taking a documentation or a fee. A second thing, do not fall into a trap of making a payment every 2 weeks. So this is 100% a scam. To be exact, there's 4.2 weeks in a month. So what they're trying to do is, over the course of the year, they're trying to pull out of you two extra payments. So don't fall into this every 2 weeks of payment. Another thing that I've seen, a little less common in our industry, but a weekly payment. Do not fall into this weekly payment. There's 52 weeks in a year and only 12 months. So they're trying to get a couple of extra payments from you when they lock you into a weekly payment. Also, a weekly payment of X amount looks a lot less than your monthly payment. So make sure that your finance agreement, that you have a monthly payment in there. When you get approved from the dealership, so I hate seeing bill of sales and the financing agreement coming from the dealership. 99% of the time, the dealership gets a kickback from the finance company in order to find the client. And another thing that happens very regularly is that the dealership that's working with the finance company, so let's say you submit an application to the dealership's finance company. The finance company is going to come back to the dealership and give them an interest rate of 8% or 9%. The dealership, what they do with the salesman is that they throw at you, instead of the actual interest rate, they'll give you 3 or 4% higher than that. And the salesman is going to see your reaction on what he thinks he can get away with you. So the finance company is going to say 8%. The dealership is going to come back at you at 11%. And if he got away with it, all of a sudden he's going to tell you, oh, I can throw this warranty and I can throw this extra thing for you, and I can give you this for free and that for free. Well, guess what? It's not for free, because you're paying for it. He just needs to justify the charges of what he's giving you for free. And the way that he does it is through the finance company that's financing at a much higher rate. Another thing that I see a lot of is the drivers are not really looking at the fine print. So sometimes I see a late payment charge of $250, an application fee, I see an early buyout fee, and I see a NSF fee. So NSF fees really should not be more than $50. I've seen them at $250. The early buyout fee, they're really shouldn't be such a big charge for an early buyout fee. Maybe just $250 fee or $300 fee for buying out early, because it is extra paperwork for them. But the paperwork anyways, they would have done at the end of your lease in order to transfer it to your name. I believe these are scams and you can easily negotiate all these things. So now let's go into the second topic, is how I would recommend, or what I feel like would be a much better way of choosing the finance company. So number one, I would choose a finance company well before I choose a truck. So what I would do is I would go to my home branch. For me, let's say it's RBC, other people use TD or Scotia. I would go to the home branch, I would get a bill of sale from any dealership, ask them to draft me a bill of sale for approximately the value that you want to buy a truck. So for example, let's say it is $80,000, $90,000, or $100,000. I would take this bill of sale and I would submit it to my finance company, whoever it is, my home branch, and then I would find two or three other companies that are doing financing for trucks. So what I would do is I would spend $30 or $40 to get my Equifax report, and I would submit it with an application with a bill of sale. So I would submit it to company A, company B, and company C, and I would ask them not to pull my Equifax report. I would ask them to give me an initial approval based on the information that I submitted to them. So based on my Equifax report, based on the bill of sale that I submitted, and you tell them approximately how much you're going to be putting, whether it's 10, 15, or 20% down payment, and they should be able to get back to you with your, number one, very important, your amortization schedule. Before you make a decision on which company you're going, finance company, you want to see the amortization schedule. And the second thing is your monthly payments and how much for how long. You should be telling them how many months you want to finance the truck, not them telling you. And make sure you tell all three or four companies that you're approaching the exact same information. So you can draft up an email, you can attach all the documents, and in that email say, I'm looking for financing for a truck. I'm going to be putting $10,000 down, and I would like to finance the remainder of it over the course of 3 years. And then you can actually compare apples to apples. Now, people are afraid to negotiate with them. I don't know why. It's very common when somebody gives you a 6% or 7% or 9% interest rates, it's very common to tell them, hey, your interest rates are not competitive. I got something cheaper. Can you do anything better? Okay, so what I would do is, if you have three or four of them, you get to play with them, not them playing with you. So one guy is gonna come back at you and say, you know what, the best I could do is drop a quarter off. And then the second guy is gonna tell you the best I could do is drop a half a percent off. And you can keep playing with them until they start dropping off whoever the last one stands, and you get the best price for yourself. So don't be afraid to negotiate with these finance companies. So once you negotiate with the finance companies, then only then go out and purchase your truck, okay? Don't do it in reverse, because then you're gonna feel pressured with time. You're most likely gonna give up the job that you're at right now. It's gonna take you at least until you plate the truck with the new company. And the last thing you want is to go into more debt while you're not working. So try doing everything in reverse. Get the finance company lined up first, then do your research on the truck that you want, the exact truck that you want, and then have the pre-approval already from the finance companies. So here's a perfect place to start. When you click the link below, it's going to take you to a page like this. Input your information here: your first name, last name, email address, and phone number. Let them know your approximate credit rating, whether it's excellent, good, below average, or poor, and let them reach out to you and get you the rates that you want for your next truck or financing needs. Do not buy a used truck with only 5 or 7% down. Okay, this is where they grab you. This is where they really, you know, when you own a home and when you have assets, this is where they don't care on the terms that they give you. They'll give you 60 months. They'll give you 72 months on a used truck. They don't care, because they know that they're gonna back up that loan from your house or your asset. So beware of that. You tell them the finance conditions that you want, whether you want 36 months, on a brand new unit, you can go 48 or 60 months. I would not finance a truck, even a brand new one, with more than 60 months payments. So for those that have really good credit or mediocre credit, and those who have saved up their down payment for a truck, I do recommend financing a truck, because you are able to go from carrier to carrier and you're not locked into one truck in a lease purchase program. So I do like financing over lease. You know, if you are doing a lease purchase program, I feel those are different drivers that have maybe not so good credit and that are not able to come up with the down payment for a truck. I do like the financing over the lease purchase program also, because there's no buyouts at your truck. I've heard some horror stories of truck drivers who were in a lease program, and then after 5 years, their buyout was $50,000. The truck was only worth about $30,000. They never end up buying and owning their own truck. The financing, the banks are a little bit smarter than that. They know what the truck is worth after 4 years, and they will only allow a buyout of maybe half of that value. So for example, after the 5 years, if the truck is only worth $40,000, the max balloon payment they'll put in the back is half that value at $20,000. So you will want to pay it off. When you're financing your truck, you have the flexibility of making larger payments. So for example, let's say your payment is $2,000 a month, you're able to put $2,200, $2,300, $2,400. You're able to make double payments and even triple payments if you have a really good year. And that's why I like financing a truck. The cons, not so great, is you need good credit in order to get a good interest rate. You might need more money up front to finance in a truck as opposed to the lease operator options. Another downfall to financing a truck is that your credit will get affected if you miss a payment or if you have a late payment. Another thing I don't like about the finance companies is if you run into really, really big problems, a big repair, or if something happens to your truck, they will still come after you for the money, for the balance. So for example, let's say, you know, your engine blew up, you didn't want to fix it, you still owe $30,000 on your truck. They will come after you for that $30,000. They don't care. They'll take away your house. They'll take away whatever they can. They are brutal. So the last thing I want to leave you with is whatever option you do choose, don't set yourself up for failure, okay? Trucks only have a duration today of maybe 7 to 9 years, not more than that. Don't finance that truck. If you're buying a used truck that's 4 years old or 3 years old, don't finance your truck for the next 5 years. You're really just setting yourself up for failure. I like financing where you get to make your payment a little bit larger in the first 2 years and smaller over the next 2 years. So for example, if you're paying $3,000 a month for a brand new unit or a two-year-old unit, if you're paying $3,000 a month for the first 2 years, I'd like to see that payment go down to $2,000 for the third and fourth year. And the reason for that is as trucks get older, there's repairs. And the last thing you want to do is get stuck with a big repair and you have your lease, right? So if you have a big repair and you still have to pay $3,000 a month, it's gonna be very hard and you can very easily fall into debt. Okay, so I have seen leases that are really, really unique and custom, and I like them because the first 2 years you have X, the third and fourth year your payments are a lot smaller. So don't fall into these financing scams that these finance companies do. Make them compete against one another. Do not just go to one and do not go to the dealership's recommended finance company. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Ronen, I'll catch you in the next one.